How are you guys doing? Today is Tuesday, September 7th, 2021. I'm James Sims, and for this episode of The Elite, I'm going to do an individual elite profile on Donovan Mitchell. The elite shooting guard for the Utah Jazz turns 25 today, and my intent with this episode is to bring light to what he's been able to accomplish and achieve throughout his amazing basketball career, from the moment he hit the main stage in the ACC at Louisville to where he is right now, widely regarded as one of the most dynamic scorers in the NBA, even considering some sources have him listed as shorter than 6'3", which is still incredibly short for the shooting guard position in the NBA. Of course, because he's small and he's on this list at that position, it shows that he's incredible. Like I mean, it kind of points to the fact that he is incredibly skilled in what he can do, and he's just incredibly athletic and bouncy to actually make up that difference and more. Not to mention that even at the age of 25, he was the best player on the best team in the regular season in the NBA yesterday. And I think right now we still haven't even reached the tip of the iceberg. So, going into Donovan Mitchell, just to give a little bit of background, he's originally from Elmsford, or I guess he came up in New York, went to high school in Connecticut and New Hampshire, up in the New England area. He would eventually go play college basketball at Louisville, where he would go on to play two seasons there would end up being Rick Pitino's final two seasons with the Louisville team, after he had to step down due to assistant coaches doing stuff with his, I'm not going to get into that. Rick Pitino is no longer the coach of Louisville, but his last 2 years there were when Donovan Mitchell was there. Donovan Mitchell's freshman season was his 2015-16. He would go on to start 5 of the 31 games he would play in his age 19 season. In that season, the Louisville Cardinals would end up with a 23-8 record. They didn't even make the tournament that year. But in college, out of the 31 games he played, he averaged about 7.4 points, 3.4 rebounds, an assist and a half, while shooting 44% from the field and 25% from three, 45% from the line. I mean, a lot of his fortune would change. His sophomore season, he would become a full-time starter for the Louisville Cardinals. He would start 34 of the 34 games in Rick Pitino's final season, a season where the Cardinals would end up losing in the second round of the March Madness tournament, but regardless, they made it. In his sophomore season, while averaging 32.3 minutes a game, Donovan Mitchell would average 15.6 points per game, which is more than doubling what he did the previous season. He did all this while shooting 41% from the field, 35% from three, which not that many people saw coming. And he was making 2.5 threes a game, so he was taking them. And he was also shooting 80.5% from the free throw line. And in addition to his 15.5 points in his sophomore season, his age 20 season, he would average 4.9 rebounds, 2.7 assists, and 2.1 steals on the season as well. He would go on to make the first team All-ACC in the 2017 season, and he would establish himself as a good enough prospect to be taken with the 13th overall pick on the 2017 NBA draft. He was drafted by the Denver Nuggets draft day and then traded to the Utah Jazz. Also, looking at that draft for players that have made just in that lottery, Jason Tatum and Bam Adebayo were other players in that draft that have made the All-Star game as of now. Tatum was the third pick in that draft, and he's the elite small forward for the Celtics. And then Bam Adebayo, the elite big man for the Miami Heat, was the 14th pick in that draft, the pick right after Donovan Mitchell. And I guess looking before, Donovan Mitchell was picked right after Luke Kennard, who plays the same exact position, by the Pistons. Once the Jazz drafted Donovan Mitchell, it would only take him about 8 games or so to earn himself into the starting lineup. In his rookie season in 2017-2018, he would go on to start 71 of the 79 games he would play for a Utah Jazz team that would go 48-34. They would make the playoffs for the second year in a row. This is when Rudy Gobert won his first defensive player of the year, the first time that a Utah Jazz player won an individual award since Karl Malone won the 1999 MVP. But regardless, going back to Donovan Mitchell in his rookie season, while averaging 33.4 minutes a game, he would average 20.5 points per game. game. It's very rare for a rookie to average 20.5 points per game, especially when he's a lot smaller than the average NBA player. He averaged 20.5 points per game while shooting 44% from the field, 34% from three, and 80.5% from the line. So, of course, shooting incredibly well from the field. In addition to his 20.5 points, he averaged 3.7 rebounds, 3.7 assists, and a steal and a half per game, like 0.3 blocks. At the conclusion of the season, the Utah Jazz, like I said, they would finish with the fifth best record in the season. And in his first season, he would go on, Donovan Mitchell would go on to be the NBA Rookie of the Year runner-up to Ben Simmons, but he would go on to win the NBA Slam Dunk Contest champion in his first year. So, of course, he showed the league what his bounce was like. And once he made the playoffs for the first time, the Jazz would end up beating the Thunder in six before losing in the conference semis to the Rockets. And then, of course, for context, this was the season where the Golden State Warriors would win their second with Kevin Durant at the helm. Following his rookie season, Donovan Mitchell will come back for his second season, his first season as a full-time starter with the Utah Jazz. In his age 22 season, he would start all 77 games in a season where the Utah Jazz finished with a 50-32 record. They won two more games in the previous season and finished with the fifth best record in the West again. This year, Rudy Gobert would win his second straight Defensive Player of the Year as well. Donovan Mitchell in the season would see his minutes stay at about the same, at about 33.7 as opposed to 33.4. He would see his points per game increase from 20.5 to 23.8, all while shooting 43% of the field, what he was shooting the previous season. His three-point percentage went up from 34 to 36%, and he would shoot just about 80.5% from the free throw line what he did the year before. In addition to his 23.8 points per game, he averaged 4.1 rebounds, 4.2 assists, and 1.4 steals, all while helping lead Utah Jazz to the playoffs again. Once they made the playoffs, they would end up losing in the very first round to the Rockets. This was the year where the Toronto Raptors would take home the title. Following the 2018-19 season, this will lead us into Donovan Mitchell's third season with the Utah Jazz, his age 23 season in 2019-2020. And this was a season that many people will remember was heavily impacted by COVID-19 to the point where it delayed the end of the season, put everyone in a bubble. And I mean, it kind of forced a short off season, which led to a lot of players being injured this most recent season. But I digress. Going into that season itself, Donovan Mitchell would start all 69 of the games he would play for a Utah Jazz team that would finish 44-28 with the sixth best record in the West. In his third season in the league, Donovan Mitchell would go on to be named an All-Star for the first time in his career. And of course, it definitely wasn't the last. While averaging 34 minutes a game, he would average 24 points per game. While shooting 45% from the field, roughly, he would shoot 36% from three, what he was doing the year before, and then he shot 86% from the foul line. In addition to his 24 points per game, he was averaging 4.4 rebounds, 4.3 assists, and a steal. And this time, he was finally rewarded for all his hard work. And once the Jazz made the playoffs, they would end up having to get defeated by the Denver Nuggets, as they led for a portion of the series, but the Nuggets would come back and eventually beat them in the series. Donovan Mitchell and Jamal Murray would go down as I don't know if it was like one of the only playoff games where both players scored like 50 points, but Donovan Mitchell was a part of like some crazy games like that, and he has dropped 50 in playoff game in at least one playoff game that I know of. But following that season, this would lead into Donovan Mitchell's most recent season, the 2020-2021 campaign. In his age 24 season, he would go on to start all 53 of the games he played for a Utah Jazz team that would finish 52-20 with the best record in the West. This would go on to be the first time that the Utah Jazz have had the best record in the NBA since 1997-98, when Michael Jordan won his second championship. But right there, in this season, Donovan Mitchell would average about 33 minutes a game, what he was doing, the exact amount of minutes he was averaging his freshman season. This most recent season, he went on to average a career high 26.4 points per game while shooting 44% from the field, 38.6% from three, which is also a career high. He went on to shoot 84.5% from the foul line. In addition to his career high 26.4 points per game, he's also averaging 4.4 rebounds, which is tied for what he did the previous season, which is currently a career high. He went on to average a career high 5.2 assists. He also averaged a steal per game as well. And at the conclusion of the season, the Utah Jazz would end up beating the Grizzlies in the first round before losing in six to the Clippers in the conference semis. And this was after Donovan Mitchell got seriously hurt. This most recent season, he would deal with, he was dealing with a lot of, with an ankle injury, which sidelined him for the final games of the regular season. He would miss, but he did miss a couple games this season. But regardless, when he did show up, he was one of the, if not, he and Rudy Gobert were two of the main reasons why the Utah Jazz finished with the best record in a very contentious West this most recent season. And Donovan Mitchell was their leading scorer. He took that pressure upon his shoulders all by himself, knowing that he's shorter than the average shooting guard, knowing that many people would count him out. The fact that he was, many people counted him out when he was at Louisville. There were 12 teams that chose someone over him, knowing what he did at Louisville, and he went on to prove them all wrong, and I can't wait to see what he does with his career. Of course, I want to thank the NBA reference, college basketball reference websites, along with the NBA websites for the facts and figures that I needed for this episode. I want to thank everyone for listening to all 11, 12 minutes of this piece. I hope all is well, and if you ever get a chance, please watch Donovan Mitchell. He's wearing number 45 for the Utah Jazz, and it's a matter of time before he represents Team USA at FIBA or the Olympics. And with that said, like, he's turning 25 today. It could be very possible that he hasn't even touched his very best, like, NBA games yet, not even close. But with that said, I can't wait to see what comes of this. And once again, today is Tuesday, September 7th, 2021. I want to take this time to wish Donovan Mitchell a happy 25th birthday. Once all of today's exhibitions and matchups are done, I will come back tomorrow on Wednesday, September 8th for a new episode of The Elite. And in terms of Donovan Mitchell, hopefully by this time next year, I'll have more to say about Donovan Mitchell as he continues to grow what could be a Hall of Fame career. Thanks once again for listening to this piece. I hope all is well, and I'll catch you with another episode after this. Thanks. And once again, today is Tuesday, September 7th. I'm James Sims. Thanks for listening to this piece, and peace out. I'll catch you tomorrow.